a few minutes late getting started, but you're very, very welcome to our second ceremony of the day, which will include students from animal care, beauty, hairdressing, professional cookery, sports management, animal science, equine, and all our other science areas, of which there are many. We're going to, first of all, welcome our guests of honour for the day, and then we're going to ask our music students to play us in as we welcome all our graduates. So I'm very, very delighted to welcome John McGinnity from Maynooth University, Councillor Damien O'Reilly, who's on our Board of Management, James Moriarty from Mark Sharp and Dome, and Aisling Sheridan from LMETB. Please welcome our distinguished guests of honour today. Students from Animal Care 1 and 2. Along with Catherine Lennon, their mentor. By Beauty Therapy 1 with Sarah. And Beauty Therapy 2 with Yvonne Byrne Kearns. Welcome hairdressing 1 and 2 with their tutor Shauna O'Brien. Followed by Animal Science Level 5, Catherine Lennon. They'll be followed by the Level 6 in Animal Science, Catherine Lennon's group as well. Followed by Equine Level 6, Catherine Lennon and Siobhan Cooney. And they're followed by Equine and Science Level 5, Siobhan Cooney as well. We now welcome Science One, Catherine Hayden. And they'll be followed by Science Two and Science Three, Catherine Hayden as well, and Fiona Holy. Wasn't that just a beautiful way to open our ceremony today? The Dunboyne College Music Department, Sound, Media. I'm always amazed each year, because we only have 1 year courses in general, this pool of talent that's come steadily through Dunboyne College over many, many years. And I'm sure Susan and Rob and others are delighted that's the case. But this year is no different. Very unique talent, lovely singers, beautiful musicians. So thank you so much for such a lovely opening. You're all very welcome to Dunboyne College graduation ceremony. This is our second one of the day, and we're going to have four over 2 days, and it allows us to get everybody in to celebrate the wonderful occasion that it is. So today, as I said, we're graduating so many different areas, from animal care, hair, beauty, sports, equine science, animal science. It's wonderful to see so many people in so many disciplines going out into the world today. My name is Dennis Leonard, I'm the principal. I'm very proud to greet you today and say how delighted we're all together in post-COVID times. Well, whatever post-COVID is going to mean from now on, but it certainly means we're able to gather here today, and that's a huge gift. So we're delighted to see all of you in person. You're all looking so well in your caps and gowns, so well turned out. Not the usual attire I'm used to seeing around the college, I must say, but you're looking extremely well. You probably don't recognize some of your classmates. I certainly don't recognize some of the staff today, but not that they don't always dress well, but they're dressing particularly well today to celebrate yourselves. So we want to wish you and your families every, you know, enjoyment of today, and you should celebrate it. I want to particularly welcome our guests of honor, our third league level colleague, Dr. John McGinnity from Maynooth University, who's their admissions officer and assistant registrar, who's befriended this college for 19 years solid, and I mean solid, and we're delighted, John, that you're with us today. Councillor Damien O'Reilly from our Board of Management. From LMETB, we have Aisling Sheridan, and we're delighted that James Moriarty of one of the local industries here, Mark Sharp and Dome, who's also a member of our Board of Management, provides invaluable advice to us, is also able to join us. So we have people from many sectors here today, and we're delighted that, you know, from the world of local politics, from education, from industry, and that's the way it should be, because they're the stakeholders that have always stood beside us as we've grown. Just a few housekeeping. As you can see, there's two exits there at the back. There's two here at the side as well. And please turn off all mobile phones or keep them on silent. You're certainly welcome to take pictures as the students go across. Now, I'll mention this again before we start the actual conferring ceremony, but for everyone that's going to come up here, you're going to come up here to the right beside the projector here. That's where you receive your cert from one of our four distinguished guests. And then you go over there to the side where those four chairs are, and you'll go straight over there to get your picture taken as a group, which you're welcome to acquire afterwards. And from that point, the student of the year in each of the groups will be called out. So that's always a very exciting time. Just relax for a moment and think about what you've accomplished. Abraham Lincoln, one of the great American presidents, once said, "Give me 6 hours to cut down a tree, and I'll spend the first 4 hours sharpening the axe." So your axes now are well sharpened, and you're well able to cut down a few trees. Always plant one in its place, of course. But it's very important that you realize all you've accomplished. So treasure this moment, take a deep breath. Arrive here, if you go out for a nice meal or go to a concert or go to a great game or sporting event, you always feel you've arrived in the stadium or the venue, whatever. Make sure you arrive here today, settle into the seat, get the 2 feet on the ground and say, "I'm here, I'm graduating from Dunboyne College." It's a wonderful moment and enjoy it. It's a special day for you and your family. And make sure that over the course of today, you thank your family, parents, brothers, sisters, whoever the partners, whoever the support people are in your life, whoever the people are who made it possible for you to sit here today, make sure at some point today you say thank you, because we appreciate their support, as I'm sure you do. So breathe it in, enjoy the day. Moments like this are very important. They're landmarks in our life. They're days we look back on, so make sure you treasure it. We're delighted you came to Dunboyne College. We're a very proud college, the only dedicated further education college in County Meath, West Dublin and North Kildare. We probably serve a demographic of 400,000 people. We have 1,000 students coming through every year. Over 8,000 have come through our doors or sat where you're sitting today. So it's fantastic that that has happened over the last 19 years. We were just approved for in excess of a 40 million euro campus development, which will be built over the next 3 years here in Dunboyne for up to 1,500 students, which will include apprenticeships, traineeships, courses for employers, employees, the whole lot. So we're growing quite rapidly. And that's down to our students like yourself who've come here and passed down the word about the importance of further education and what it offers. Your families, a very dedicated staff here that I could never say enough about. I'm always saying they're the best staff in Ireland. I'm sure many principals say that, but I just feel it's the truth here. And many, many stakeholders from industry, politics, local industry, local community, small and medium businesses, people who give you work experience, people who support us every step of the way. You've put your trust in us, and therefore the government has now put their trust in Dunboyne College to deliver the first ever further education and training college of the future, which will be built here in Dunboyne. It'll be a prototype for all the others that will follow, and it'll be the only one of its kind purpose-built campus in the proud county of Meath. So we're delighted about that announcement. I'm sure about a year ago, many of you probably wrote personal statements, and this time of year, I'd be reading through them, you know, to see who's coming to us in September. And I was just reading one yesterday, and just something struck me about it. She spoke about, you know, some of the difficulties she had in secondary school and getting herself over the line and getting to her next step in her education. And after the first or second paragraph, she said, "That is where Dunboyne College comes in. If I complete this PLC course, I will get a Laboratory Techniques Award, which will give me a place in my dream course. There are also many other benefits. I would get to learn more about what I would like to do in the future, what my future course would be. I would get more experience and become more knowledgeable, so I'll be prepared for third level. I would be even more ready for what the course will entail than if I just went straight in. A one-year course is an easier commitment, and I would also have the opportunity to get work experience, which is so valuable. That is why Dunboyne is so attractive to me." And that's why students like herself, and like all of you here today, are so attractive to us, because you tell our story in the way we can't always tell it. It works. If you work with it, if you put your trust in us for your progression to higher education, and work with our wonderful guidance team of Derek and Maeve to get there, or onto a pre-employment or onto an employment course or another further education course, we will actively work with you and meet you halfway to make that dream a reality. It's on that simple premise and that simple trust that we have grown and how we've excelled. Mutual trust is what we are for each other and what we can offer each other. We have a wonderful staff here and superb students. And I never saw that more true than during COVID, when literally in March of a few years ago, everything collapsed and we had to go online within a week and everybody had to adapt, staff and students. And you came this year and you adapted, whether we were all in, half in, blended learning, practicals, whatever it took to get yourself to here today, you did it. And you can be very proud of that, because you came through a fifth and sixth year in many cases, you know, with the blended learning, and you had to do it here as well in a one-year course, and you've come out the other side. So I think you owe a great gratitude to your own forbearance and perseverance when you saw that that happened. We're very proud as well that we're now a green campus as well. Many of you contributed to our green flag, which was raised over the college a few weeks ago, only the 20th in the entire country, and one of few further education colleges that have it. So because you've contributed to making sure that we're also a sustainable campus going forward. One of our recent graduates wrote to us and said that with hard work and determination, and with the quality education Dunboyne offers, you can accomplish the same goals and achievements that I've had the privilege to experience. She's now in Maynooth University, and she's part of our Graduate Association. We hope you'll become part of the Graduate Association. And please, when Maeve or Derek or someone else writes to you in August or September and or October, whatever it is, and says, "Where are you? Please tell us." Take the time to just put a couple of lines in that email and say, "I'm now here," or "I'm doing this," or "I'm waiting for this to happen," or whatever the case is, because we love to know not just that you've done well with us, but where you're going in the future and what that means for you. Emu will thank everyone at the end by name, but I want to just mention a few people that I want to, as principal, say my personal gratitude to. Hilda Coughlin, who could organize absolutely anything. Rome wasn't built in a day, but Hilda wasn't there, I can tell you. Her excellent events team that she puts together. Wonderful support staff here in the college that work with her. Rob and Susan and everyone who works, I won't name you all, Emma will later, but all of you who work to make this music, the sound, the fact that we're live streaming today, I want to say hello to everyone at home or everyone who's watching us here and abroad. It's wonderful that not just the people in the room during COVID times can actually enjoy this ceremony, but people all over Ireland and wider afield. I want to thank everyone in our support staff, our caretakers, our secretary, everybody who works each day, our learning support team, who are second to none. We pride ourselves on that. You know, universities think they're the best access team. I know that the people who come to us, they always get the support they need, because we have quality people there to make sure they get it, and same with guidance. So I hope that you took advantage of that this year, and I'm sure many of you are here because of their support. I want to also thank Joanna Daw and Bernie Leahy and their team involved in a great publication you're going to hear about shortly. And RLRD for the great newsletter that was on your, the parents would have received when you came in. That shows you just some of the events that we've been involved in over the last few months, and it shows the wealth of activity that goes on here in the college. And last but not least, I want to thank our teaching staff who make so much possible, especially in challenging years like this. Nothing ever seems too big a challenge for them to take on. And, you know, I'm always shuddering to ask certain things you have to ask of them on certain weeks or certain days, but they always seem to rise to the challenge. And it's a great testament to their professionalism and what the relationship they have with you and with each other means to them. So whether you come back to us to do a level six, progress on to one of the great third level courses or enter employment, this is the beginning, this is your day. We are here to help you to celebrate. One of the students at the last ceremony who was speaking said, you need the courage to be seen in the light of your own glory. Well, make sure you're seen in the light of your own glory today. So now I want to say enjoy this special moment, and I'd like to welcome Aisling Sheridan, who's the Adult Education Director with LMETB, to welcome you here on behalf of the organisation that we're proud to be a part of, the Louth and Meath Education Training Board.
Good afternoon, everybody, and it's wonderful to be here. I have to say, it's very hard to come up here after, number one, the fabulous music. Well done. It was exceptional and set a lovely tone, I think, to everybody coming in. So well done on that. And also to come after Dennis Leonard, who is an amazing principal and, you know, and as you can see, runs a fabulous college, which you've all been part of. So, but look at... as Dennis has said, my name is Aisling Sheridan, and I am delighted to be here with you all this afternoon to share in the celebration. You know, and it is a celebration, and today is about each and every one of you here. It's about the challenges that you've had to overcome to be here today, the determination and resilience that it took to achieve what you set out to do, and the persistence to move forward in both your personal and professional lives. And I'm glad that Dennis mentioned it, because I think it's really important to mention the families and friends here today as well, who have supported you all along the way. And no doubt they've had sacrifices to make too. So this is a joint celebration. And you know, do reach out later today and thank everybody who's supported you in terms of getting here, because that's really important. So look, I'm delighted to be back here face to face. It's been 2 long years of really not having an opportunity to come to events like this and celebrate and meet the students and remind us all why it is we do the job we do. Because believe you me, day in, day out, when you're looking at policies and programs and strategies, it would be very easy to forget what this is all about. And today is that reminder. So today, it's the reminder that what we do is to achieve your goals, to support you along the way, and to be there to make your dreams, whatever they are, to make those a reality. So I suppose, look, it is fair to say, I think for every single one of us, no matter what age you are, what background you are, what stage of life you are, it's not easy to come to education or to come back to education. It's a challenge, and it should be. And I'm sure it was a daunting prospect for you coming through the doors of Dunboyne College that very first day. But you hung in there, you stayed the course, and with the help of everyone around you, you achieved what you set out to do. So I am honoured to be here today to celebrate that with you. And I would have to say, look, in my role as AEO, I am privileged that I do get to meet, you know, so many different learners from so many walks of life, backgrounds, experiences. But there's one thing that everybody has in common, and that is a determination to progress, to succeed on a personal and professional level. And for that, I commend you all. I'd like to think that LMETB in its entirety, of which Dunboyne College is one of our fantastic post-leaving cert colleges, is a safe haven for anyone with a desire or a need to come back into education. So when you enter these doors, there are staff on hand to help you and who really want to achieve as much as you want to achieve yourself. So with that in mind, I'd like to take this opportunity to very much thank the management team, primarily the principal here beside me, Dennis Leonard, and the amazing deputy principals, Catherine Fox, Irene Toher, and Emer Cloak. All the supportive staff, the guidance team, and the amazing teachers, who are too numerous to mention, but you know yourselves, without these people, we couldn't be here today. So maybe we just give them a wee boulibus before we move on. So look, without further ado, I just want to salute you for all that you've achieved, wish you every success in your future path, be that going forward into education or into a career. Either way, what you have learned in Dunboyne College will stand to you. So just remember, when days are tough, and sometimes they are, take the time to remember today all that you have achieved and all that you are capable of. And it was a saying that I once heard. I don't know who to attribute this one to, but it stuck with me anyway. Education is the passport to the future, for tomorrow belongs to those who prepare for it today. Congratulations. Well done. Enjoy your day. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Aisling. And I'd like, on behalf of all our college here, thank LMETB for their constant support. The girls in the office in Navan and Dundalk, you know, RC, Martin O'Brien, Director for the Red, Sadie Ward McDermott, Aisling, who's head of adult education. Every one of them is always at the end of a phone for any difficulty that we might have. So thank you so much for that. We're now delighted to welcome one of our student speakers because, as I said earlier, students telling their own story has been the way you can advertise in newspapers, you know, parents can talk to other parents, you can go on all the social media that you like, but at the end of the day, somebody, your neighbor, your friend, somebody you went to school with, you know, your older brother or sister who came through here, whatever it is, they've been telling our story for many, many years, and that seems to resonate so clearly with all of us, not just with you. So I'd like to welcome Saive Wirala Adeneni, who's actually a beauty student here, and Saive is going to share a little bit about her experience here in Dunboyne College this year. Saive, please come forward. Thank you.
I don't want to write anything down, so I want it to be sincere. A bit about me. This is actually a second ceremony for me. I already have a bachelor's in politics and information social computing from UCD. And I have to say that although this ceremony kind of hits different, I'm really proud of myself, and I'm sure you guys are so proud of yourselves too. It's been such a tough year. It's been so new, so different with everything. Some coming from college, some coming from their own careers, and some, like me, from education. It was a tough year, but we're here. That's fantastic. Even like with everything, the teachers, COVID, just being on school grounds, having to be online sometimes, in class other times, but we made it work. And honestly, Dunboyne has been amazing to me. The support, the staff, shout out to Yvonne and Sarah, thank you. Honestly, everyone's been so fantastic, even receptionist, groundskeeper, whenever I'm lost, which I was lost a lot, but everyone was just so happy to help. And do you know what, I saw that everywhere, just the eagerness to help and the willingness to just support. Dunboyne has been amazing. Thank you guys so much for everything. And oh my God, guys, you actually made it. I'm so happy. So thank you so much.
That's a dream for us. You can turn around after 9 months with us and say, I'm so happy. Now, I'm very happy to reintroduce our wonderful music department, and they're going to play a song now, but if you look up at the screen here, while they're playing, we've had a lovely montage put together by Will and Claire, and a lot of people. Keenan takes a lot of great pictures around the place, and so many others. And people took photos during the year. Some are in our newsletter. Obviously, it was too many to put in the newsletter. So you'll have a little chance to see what your sons and daughters and brothers and sisters were up to during the year and what Dunboyne College looks like on a day-to-day basis. So I'll hand over to our music department, and please enjoy our montage.
Bed with a broken heart while I'm drinking. Jack all alone in my local bar. We don't know how we got into this mad situation. Only doing things out of frustration. Trying to make it work, but man, these times are hard. God says, someone help us, cause we're doing our best. Trying to make it work, but man, these times are hard. So we're gonna stop by drinking on cheap bottles of wine. Shit talking up all night, saying things we haven't for a while, yeah. We're smiling, but we're close to tears. Even after all these years, we just now got the feeling that we're meeting for the first time. Just now got the feeling that we're meeting for the first time.
Happened during a COVID restricted year, so you can imagine how hard people had to work to make sure all those events happened, and the students were so wonderful in taking part in so many different activities, so thank you for that. And I said at the past ceremony, but to see how the montage finished at the same time as the music, like, these guys are like just total professionals. They have everything down to a fine art, you know. When we started off here, I think 2000, many years ago anyway, with a small music department and Susan with a few singers in a corner, and next thing they needed someone to mix, and then they needed someone to, you know, to play the different instruments, and then they needed a whole media department to film them. And, you know, I mean, it just seemed to have grown from such a small, you know, seed into such a huge tree. So thanks, guys, for the beautiful music, and thanks to those put together the montage. It was absolutely lovely. Now I want to introduce Joanna Daw, who's going to talk to you about a wonderful publication. This year, we really needed to mark I suppose it was post the Aisling Murphy time, and it struck the whole country, but it brought home to us, you know, what has happened, you know, to so many women throughout the world who suffer prejudice or discrimination from the government they're living under, or people that they're supposed to be working for, whatever it happens to be. And we see what's happened in Ukraine today, and we remember them as well. But Joanna and her merry band from the north, Fiona and Patrice, decided to get together, worked with Bernie Lee in her art department, to put together a beautiful publication to mark Women's Day, of course, on the 8th of March. And it was a wonderful month for us. We also marked, you know, Green Week and Health Week. And, you know, we got some activities going after the long COVID break. But she's produced something really, really wonderful. And we're happy to say that there is one for everyone in the audience, like Ryan Tuberty would say, that when you receive your certificate today, you're going to see a copy of a wonderful contribution. I know some of you contributed to, staff, students, people from all over the country. But I'll let Joanna Daw tell the story of Voices.
Hello, everybody. Good afternoon. I have a speech written, but I probably won't use it as I normally ad-lib these things, but I'll try to stick to script as best I can. So as Dennis said there, you know, I was very lucky and I felt very privileged to be involved in a project this year with a lot of my colleagues in this school all got on board, and it was actually the idea of Patrice Byrne. She was said we celebrate International Women's Day. So we thought, well, what can we do? So over the years, just to go back a little bit, over the years, and I've been teaching communications for a very long time, probably when there were pigeons were going taking messages, that's when I was teaching communications. But over the years, I would say to my students as part of the course, you know, I want you to do a piece of personal writing for me, whether it be a poem or whether it be a short story or anything. It can be a limerick, it can be anything. And, you know, it was always met with such resistance. Why are you making us do this? I never liked doing this in primary school, and blah, 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 and all the rest of it, and on it went. And anyway, as usual, I forced them into doing it. So anyway, you know, over the years, my students have produced some amazing pieces of work that I have never been able to, you know, discard. And I've kept them. I could literally paper two rooms with some of the poetry and some of the short stories that have been written. And I always think, if you want to know somebody, get to know them, or really know the person in front of you, you read something, you know, that they have written, especially when it's something very personal, because I have found them to be, you know, very profound, a lot of the writings. So this year, you know, because of the pandemic, you know, it was such a difficult year. We said, well, let's try to get something positive out of it. So with the help of the Women's International Day committee, and myself and Bernie Leahy. Bernie Leahy is a visual artist, and she's our art lecturer in the college. We got together with our other team, and, you know, we put these writings into this book that we called Voices. Now, that wasn't the first time we produced a book. You know, the book, we had a book produced last year as well that we were just totally amazed by and so inspired by. So we said, well, let's do it this year for International Women's Day. And what was produced was unbelievable. Now, myself and Bernie Leahy, Bernie designed the books. You know, I decided, you know, what was going to go in. I looked for outside contributors. We were very lucky to get Joe Duffy, the broadcaster. We had Michelle O'Neill, MLA for Northern Ireland. We had Mary Lou McDonald. We had Michael Kenny from Maynooth. We had Lavinia Kerwick. We had so many outside contributors. And poets and writers from the different universities, Queen's, Galway, Maynooth, were more than happy, and they said that they were really privileged to put their name to a piece of work in this book. So it was amazing, and the reason why we're so proud of this book is because the majority of work is, you know, our students, our absolutely amazing students that continue to inspire us, you know, year after year after year with what they can do with their literary and their artistic professionalism is unbelievable. And every piece of artwork you find in this book has come from our students. And, you know, a lot of their work, students' work past and present, you know, is in there too. So we're immensely, immensely proud. Now, I wouldn't be an English literature teacher if I didn't end with a quote. And this is a quote that has always really just stood out to me. And it's by Alberto Manguel, who once said, "Maybe this is why we read and why in moments of darkness we return to books, to find words for what we already know. And it's our hope that in this book you will find enduring lessons in love, in life, in character, and in compassion that will surprise and enlighten time and time again." And I just want to give a massive thank you to our students past and present who continue to inspire us. And there's one person that I really want to thank as well, is Dennis Leonard here behind me. I go to Dennis with all these ideas, and normally with a begging bowl as well. And Dennis just nods his head and he says, "Yes, Joanna, yes, whatever you want, Joanna." It's not easier. Just get out quickly, take your begging bowl and get out, and I'll fill it with a couple of checks there for you. So really and truly, so everybody is going to get a book, and I want to thank you so much. Now, we also had presentation copies made as well for our very special guest here behind us today, and it's covered in Irish linen, and it's really something that we're extremely proud of. So I'm going to present our special guest with a copy of Voices Book 2, and thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Joanna, and it's a wonderful concept, and we're delighted that it has come to fruition, and I know it will raise awareness for so many people about the power of the written word. So now we move on to what you're all here for, the actual conferring of certificates, and you'll be happy to know that we're going to have you come up here as we call your name. I'm going to ask each of our distinguished guests to actually present some of these, and I'm going to start with Aisling Sheridan, who's actually our Adult Education Officer. She's going to come down here to the front beside the projector. So each time you'll receive, and she's going to present a few of these, maybe three or four different class groups each, our four guests will present. So she's going to present the ones in animal care. And what's going to happen is we're going to invite up Catherine Lennon now, who's going to call out their names. And as you hear your name, you'll be ushered forward to receive your cert. And then would you please go over to the side there where you see the photographer, and he'll set you up over there. So now I'll hand you over to Catherine Lennon for Animal Care 1 and 2.
Hi, everyone. Okay, I just want to say congratulations to both Animal Care 1 and Animal Care 2, and well done on all your hard work. So we're going to start with Alana Bridgman. Romantis Bacellis. Caitlin Byrne. Sheena Cunningham. Kim Farrell. Melissa Gallagher. Rebecca Grattan Teeling. Aideen Lord. Lauren Mangan. Kelsey Mooney. Simone Mulvaney. Chloe O'Brien. Sean O'Shea O'Connor. Amy O'Sullivan. Anne Sarioglu. And Laura Toomey.
Well done to Animal Care 1 and 2 and to Catherine Lennon and Ashley, their tutors. And just while they're getting the group picture taken, Colin Downey can't be with us today. He's the student winner for Animal Care 1. But we're also delighted, and I'll ask Ashling, sorry, to stay out here for another little while, because I'm going to ask you to present Beauty as well in a few moments. But before you do that, would you please present the Animal Care 2 Student of the Year Award to Laura Toomey. Well done to all our Animal Care graduates. All the cats and dogs in the country are in good hands for the next 30 or 40 years anyway. We're now moving on to Beauty Therapy, and we're going to start with Beauty Therapy 1, and this is Sarah Frawley's group, and we'll ask Ashling Shirt to present these as well to both the beauty groups, starting with Beauty Therapy 1, and she's going to call out their names now.
It's with pleasure that I present Beauty Therapy 1. We have Caitlin Carney. Ellen Durkin. Katie Edmonds. Camille Matazaita. And Jennifer Kavanagh.
Well done to everyone in Beauty Therapy 1. And before we move on to Beauty Therapy 2, just to let you know that both of our Beauty Therapy winners today in both Beauty Therapy 1 and 2 will not only receive the glassware from Dunboyne College, but they're also, and I'd like to thank Deborah Ryan, who's been involved in our beauty department for years, for this. We have a very strong relationship with Dermalogica. I couldn't even say that when we first had the partnership with them. Anyway, Dermalogica have generously sponsored a €200 student kit and a €2,000 course for both of our winners. And I'm happy to say that the winner from Beauty Therapy 1 is Camille Matazaita. Well done. I'd like to call Yvonne Byrne Kearns now to the podium, who's going to call out the recipients of graduation certificates for Beauty Therapy 2.
Good afternoon, everybody, and congratulations to everybody today graduating. In particular, the two beauty groups, and I'm just going to introduce Beauty 2 now. So we'll start with Saivor Ola Adeni. Ellen Connors. Shannon Conroy. Quiva Donne. And Kira Donnelly.
Wonderful, we're graduating so many beauticians with just high professional qualifications. So they do both the QQI and the iTech Awards. So congratulations to them. And the winner of the overall Dunboyne College Award for Beauty Therapy 2, along with the €200 Dermalogica kit and the €2,000 course, is Ellen Connors. Thank you very much to Aisling Sheridan for presenting those awards. I'd now like to ask Councillor Damon O'Reilly, who's on our Board of Management and a local councillor here in Dunboyne for many years, to present hairdressing, professional cookery and sports. So we'll start with hairdressing. Now we're presenting all these together. Zara Sheridan and Shauna are both, Zara and Shauna are both our beauty tutors for many years. Shauna O'Brien is also our adult education officer, so Aisling will know her well. And the two of them have graduated some wonderful graduates in hairdressing over the last few years. So now we're going to hear who are the graduates this year for hairdressing one and two. I'll hand over to Zara.
Congratulations, everyone, and a special congratulations to hairdressing. We have Alana Ellen Broderick. Lauren Connolly. Rebecca Dunbar. Louise McElroy. And Chloe Quinn.
So after moving from the face up to the hair, we're looking after all your needs here completely. So now we have two hairdressing awards, one for hairdressing one and one for hairdressing two. And in hairdressing one, the overall award goes to Louise McElroy. And from hairdressing two, we have Lauren Connolly. Now, I never like to show any prejudice, but I'm moving on to one of my favourite rooms in the building, professional cookery. And they produce wonderful meals and desserts and everything all year. And I know they're going to make a huge impact on the world of catering as they move out. Gillian Duff now, the chief chef and proud tutor, is going to present these awards. Gillian Duff. And I ask Councillor O'Reilly if he's there as well, please, for these as well.
Good afternoon. I just want to congratulate the students that are here from the professional cookery course to say how well you did, and thank you for teaching me so much, everything from parenting tips and TikToks, everything. So I now want to congratulate Chloe Dunn. And Sarah Jane Mongan. Avril Murphy. Sarah O'Sullivan. And Kim Smith. Well done, girls.
Well done to all of our professional cookery class, and they produce some wonderful meals during the year and some wonderful events, so they've added so much to the college. You probably saw a lot of the pictures up there. So we're delighted to announce that the Professional Cookery Student of the Year is Kim Smith. Well done, Kim. thanks to Councillor O'Reilly for making those presentations. Thank you. I'm going to move on to sports, and I'm going to call on Dr. John McGinnity to present some of these awards, as well as Animal Equine Science. He's a proud Monaghan man, a great sports supporter, and unfortunately he's meeting Mayo on Saturday week at 4 o'clock in Castlebar, so I'm sure I'll see you there. But in the meantime, he also has some fantastic developments that are going to be developing in Maynooth in the whole business sport area that I know he'll be plugging. And this must be the first event he ever came to without a stack of Maynooth prospectuses. So we're, we're delighted that you're here, and he's going to be presenting the sports awards. Paddy Sullivan is their tutor, and he's going to call out their names now.
Hi everyone, congratulations to all our students today, and a special congratulations to our sports group. So first I'd like to call up Davin Birmingham. Next we have Ross Mullen. James O'Connell. And finally, Fergal Siri.
Well done to all our sports graduates. And it gives me great pleasure to announce that the overall Sports Student of the Year for 2021-22 goes to James O'Connell. We'll ask John to stay there for animal science and equine as well. They have a fantastic equine facility in Maynooth as well. They've developed equine business, which encouraged us to do it. So I'd like to start with animal science level 5, and then and Catherine Lennon, their tutor, is going to call out the graduates for animal science level 5.
Okay, congratulations, animal science level 5, and we're going to start with Alex Boston. Laura Colligan. Sean Danae. Chloe Duran. Luke Garcia Luro. Diana Jegorova. Kaylee Lawler. Kata Anna Lovey. Aoife Moran. Jake O'Toole. Aisling Quinn. Nadine Smith. Amy Tai. And Hannah Weir.
Great to see so many graduates in the animal science area. Now, I'm going to announce the winner of the Student of the Year Award for Animal Science Level 5, and that goes to Alexandru Boston. And I'll now ask Catherine Lennon to come back and to announce the graduates in Animal Science Level 6.
Okay, congratulations, Animal Science Level 6. And firstly, Lauren Keogh. Ava Mulholland. Samantha Reynolds. And Nadia Shami.
Thank you. Now they're getting their picture taken with their mentor there, Catherine Lennon. And I'm proud to announce the winner of the Student of the Year for Animal Science Level 6, Ebna Mulholland. I'd now like to ask Siobhan Cooney, who's the tutor for the equine area, to come forward, and she's going to announce level 5 and level 6 in equine.
Hello everybody, I would like to present my level 6 equine students. They did amazing. So first up we have Emily Byrne. Jules Dixon. Olivia Doherty. Claudia Farrington. And Alexandra Machueska.
Well done to Equine Level 6, and they're going to get their picture taken with Siobhan now. And we're delighted to announce the overall Student of the Year for Equine Level 6 goes to Emily Byrne. And now Siobhan will announce the winners in Equine Science Level 5.
Well done to my level 5 equine horsemanship and equine with science students. You did brilliant. We have Niamh Devitt. Sarah Doherty. Eden Gannon. Jasmine Hughes. Sean O'Halloran. Saoirse Walker. And Sinead Walsh.
Well done to all our equine business, equine science, horsemanship. It's a wonderful course, and we're delighted that the overall winner for Equine Science Level 5 is Niamh Devitt. I'll ask John just to stay there for two more presentations. A bit like Dermalogica, we love cooperating with industry for awards, and this year Horse Racing Ireland have produced two bursaries, €1,500 each, for two of our equine graduates. And Siobhan is now going to tell us a little bit about how it came about, and she's going to tell us exactly what's involved in the award, plus the two winners.
This year, the equine department worked together with Equip, who are the education department of the Irish Thoroughbred Industries, and we had decided to do a presentation for both the level fives and the level sixes. The level sixes had to do a 20-minute presentation on just the thoroughbred industry, its achievements and so on. And the level sixes had to do comparisons between different industries that we have in Ireland. So they did. They all, both of them, the whole group was very nervous doing it. They had to talk with the HRI, and they were all very nervous. But they all did an amazing job. For the level fives, the HRI decided that Shauna Halloran would get the award, and she received a 1500 bursary. And for our level six, Jules Dixon.
Thank you, and thank you to Equip and everyone involved in that. I think it's a wonderful partnership, and it's a wonderful gift that we've been given. Thank you to Dr. McGuinness for presenting those certs as well. Now we come to our last set of graduates who are in the science area, and I'm going to ask James Moriarty, who's a scientist from around the corner here from New York, and who's come to Mark Sharpen Dome just up the road here, and he's part of our whole industry cooperation, and they've been in working with our science department many times in the past, so we're delighted that that James, he's on our board of management, is here to present these awards. So I'll call up Fiona Hoey now, who on behalf of her wonderful science department of Catherine Keenan and herself is going to present awards ranging from sports science, environmental science, all across all the science areas we now possess. So Fiona Hoey.
Congratulations to all of the pre-university science classes of 2022. First up, we have Science 1. Pauline Fordyce is your mentor, but unfortunately Pauline can't be with us today, but she does send her congratulations. So, may I call upon Sarah Davey. Dervla Finnegan. Amy Gallagher. Ryan Hegarty. Kisra Moonan. Aidan Riley. And Shadi Sun.
Well done to everyone in Science One, who are getting their pictures over there taken with Catherine Hayden. And I'd like to announce that the overall winner for Science One Student of the Year is Najaf Habib.
Okay, next up we have Pre-University Science 2, whose mentor is Catherine Hayden. So may I call upon Anne-Marie Brogan. Caitlin Fox O'Connor. Hazel King. Aoife Mulligan. Rose Palmer. And Rebecca Walsh.
Well done to all our graduates from Science 2, which includes science, agricultural science, but also includes environmental science. So we have two awards in this area. The first for science, general science, in Science 2, and it goes to Anne-Marie Brogan. And the second award is specifically for environmental science, which is obviously something we need a lot of in the country at the moment, and it's Rose Palmer.
Now, finally, Science 3, my amazing mentor group. So may I call upon Fiona Finnegan. Chloe Gaffney. Owen Breton. Fabian Kierkowski. Ava Mooney. And Hannah Prendergast. Congratulations.
Just as our Science 3 group are getting their picture taken, I can tell you that it's a mixture of general science, but also sports science and food science. So the Sports Science Award goes to Hannah Prendergast. And the Food Science Award for 21-22 goes to David O'Dea. Now, at this stage, we've had many different presentations from a huge amount of the services area, which is headed up by Susan Clark, their department head, and then the science department, which will now be headed up by Fiona Hoey. So we've had many graduates across all of these. So I'm sure at this stage, you'd like to relax and enjoy a bit of music from our music department. So I'll hand you over to our musicians.
Thank you. should I desire when we wake up and we make love? It makes me feel so nice. You're my water when I'm stuck in the desert. You're the talent all I take when my head hurts. You're the sunshine of my life. How beautiful you are. You know that I see it. I know you're a star. Where you go, I'll follow, no matter how far. If life is a movie, oh, you're the best part. If you love me, won't you say something? If you love me, won't you? Love me, won't you?
If you love me, won't you say something? If you love me, won't you?
Won't you?
If you love me, won't you say something? If you love me, won't you? Love me, won't you?
Isn't that just magic? My next life, I definitely want to be in a band. It's lovely. I'd like to introduce our guest speaker now for this afternoon, and we're delighted with the collaboration we've had with Maynooth University, really back to 2003 when we started. Someone who gave us encouragement, support, gave us an educational vision, a journey, was always available, even a few times in a week if necessary. Nothing ever seemed too much. Of all the people I've met in my life, I've rarely met anyone who's more generous with his time, with his energy, and we're delighted to welcome today a great friend of the college, the Assistant Registrar and the Admissions Officer from Maynooth University, Dr. John McGinnity.
Thank you, Dennis, and it's lovely to be here. It's a real privilege. As I was sitting here with my colleagues on the panel, the thing that struck me was just the sense of energy in the room, the energy from the students. It's just wonderful as a parent, as a guardian. And I'm conscious there's transitions in life. And you know, over the last couple of years, those moments where you had an opportunity to celebrate, maybe when you were finishing school, you just weren't able to do it. And they're important moments, and they didn't happen because you couldn't just do it in person. And it's just wonderful, and I think it's the leadership of Dunboyne College, the leadership of Dennis, of Irene, of Catherine, of Emer, the leadership, the management, the team, the teaching team, in some sense to bring us together as a community, to be here, to be with you, to congratulate you, to share this time. And I think as Dennis said earlier on, it's that moment to take that time today for you to say thanks to the people that you care about. I recall back in 2003 getting a call from Eamon Gaffney, who was the principal of St. Peter's Dunboyne. And at the time, there was Dennis, Brian McCarthy, and they had a vision. And that vision was, it was just rooted in one thing. And that one thing was, we care about our students, and we don't think they're getting a fair crack at the whip. We're not happy that the pathways and the connections that are for our 6 years who are finishing are there for them. And we're going to make a really bold step, and we're actually going to create a college. It's not every day somebody wakes up and says, we're going to create a college. But there was a vision there. And it wasn't in anything of selfishness, it was a sense of giving, a sense of the students didn't have pathways, and we're going to change things, and we want something to happen. And I mean, I was just one of the people that they would have contacted, but I just saw it. And probably the happiest moment for me today is when Dennis said that there's 40 million coming. It's not before time, and the economy, okay, the economy is under pressure, But if anything, the investment in education will return itself many, many fold. So perhaps that moment when you said 40 million has been set aside to generate a building, but can I just say, buildings are buildings. What really happens is people. Peter Drucker, who's a management consultant, I know some of the students here would have done pieces of that, but a sense of, they talk about culture eating strategy for breakfast. So often people can strategize and say, let's have a great plan. But if the people aren't there, if the culture is not there, as they say, culture eats strategy for breakfast. So even though there are changes, I think what's going to evolve is the vision and the people and the commitment in terms of a student-centered environment will sustain itself through the current buildings and also the new buildings as well. I think that's so important. Can I just compliment you? You made a very, very wise decision to go to Dunboyne College. A wise decision because it's an investment for you in your education. And that investment will return itself if you're motivated by finances. What we find is, our labour economists find, that you get about a 15% premium for every second, for every minute of the rest of your life, of your working life. But more important than that, what we find is that people who pursue courses in animal science, in beauty therapy, in hairdressing, in science, in all of the disciplines that we hear, the wonderful disciplines we hear this afternoon, but it's you, because it's from a place of, this is something I have an interest in, this is something I want to do, and it's in fulfilling in yourself is what you get progress and satisfaction from. So you get a return financially, but you'll also get a return from a transformational impact on yourself in terms of studying something that you love. And encouraging you to continue that learning in whatever guise. I mean, things are changing, as we know, in terms of what's called micro-credentials. More and more people will do bursts of learning throughout their entire life in shorter and shorter packages. And more will be available to you to actually do the learning that suits you at the time that suits you, at the pace that suits you, and, you know, in some way work from your peers in that. Can I compliment you as a set of graduates? You were graduates an hour ago, now you're graduates. That sense of resilience, more than any other graduates, that sense of through COVID and the adversity, you persevered, you completed. In life, the capacity to start something and finish it out is important. Okay, sometimes you may have to defer, sometimes you may have to stay and pause and come back to it, and that's absolutely fine. But certainly from today, there's just a celebration and enjoyment. I personally have got great enjoyment. It started with Adele, so Susan, thank you. My daughter chooses the music in our house, as we know. She's the boss. It's her choice in the car as well. So when I heard Adele, I was definitely at home. Dennis will never forgive me if I don't plug the university, Maynooth University. And if I may, I just say, in some sense, the biologists, I know the scientists in the room would talk about, James would understand this, what's called a symbiotic relationship. It's when it's win-win. And Maynooth University and Dunboyne College are in a symbiotic relationship. It's win-win. And we're very, very proud. We connect into Dunboyne College. Dunboyne College connects into Maynooth University. We connect as people. And absolutely, we're very proud. When I did a quick count, a head count, over the last 5 years, we had almost 1,000 students from Dunboyne College came to the university. That's something we're proud of. I know Dunboyne College is proud of that. And that's something, depending on what it is that you wish to do, I'm conscious many of you will want to stay in Dunboyne College to progress and make that wise decision to do a level six, progress on to some of the colleges in the hinterland, go out into the real economy and you know, earn your way in life. Whatever it is, the right thing, that's for you. And I'll actually make a huge commitment, the sense that Maynooth University, we're now at over 15,000, fastest growing university in the country. We're ambitious. Next year we're introducing a new business and with sports science degree. We have an open day on Saturday the 25th of June, so I can't go without saying that. But more important than that, I wish you well in your future. You chose wisely to come to Dunboyne College, and wish you every best and success in the rest of your life. Thank you.
I'd have been very disappointed, John, if you didn't plug the open day. And thanks for your kind words, and as I said, your support. It's meant a lot. And I know I mentioned your programme of university awards. We've had to suspend them the last couple of years because of COVID, and it's very hard to give out awards across entire faculties with the kind of years we're having. But it's something we're going to introduce again next year. And Maynooth University have been first and forefront in giving awards across a lot of disciplines, and it's a wonderful relationship. We're going to have two songs to finish up shortly. Before I do, I'd like to introduce our final speaker of the day, which is our Deputy Principal, Emer Cloak. Emer works along with Irene and Catherine and an entire management team who are so supportive to me. It's very easy for me to stand up here and represent a college, but I could not do without the wonderful leadership that these people across departments, across courses, and each of the teachers give to you as students. Emer has been there for many, many years. She's a rock of sense. She's in that learning support hub, which is like the vibrant heart of the college where everybody goes, including myself, when things aren't going well. So I do want to say, a special thanks to Emer and Irene and Catherine and all of the management team and for your fantastic work. So Emer now is going to thank everyone who made today possible before we have our final musical pieces. Emer.
Thank you, Dennis. Good evening. So for many years now, I've given the closing speech at our graduation. This, for me, is a privilege because it's a chance to have the last word with you, our students, before you leave us. It's also a chance to publicly express our gratitude to those people who make our college what it is and others who continually support us from the outside. I'd like to thank the following people who are here today. Dr. Aisling Sheridan from LMETB, Dr. John McGinnity from Maynooth University, James Moriarty from MSD, who's also on our Board of Management, and Councillor Damien Riley, who's also on our Board of Management. On behalf of our staff, I'd like to thank our Principal, Dennis Leonard. Our college would not be where it is today without your vision, your endless energy, and your drive to get things done. I'd also like to thank our management team. Thanks to you, our systems improve year on year. We're very lucky to have such a great team, and you make us look good. And to our staff. Dennis referred to you today as the best staff in Ireland. He's previously referred to you as the best staff in the world, so I think there's a bit of a demotion going on there. Whatever. I second that here today. You're an amazing staff. Every year you welcome over 1,000 different students. Get to know them, support them in a very short time frame. You constantly seek to improve on what we do for our students. You are hardworking, dynamic, innovative, the framework of the college, and above all, you are a pleasure to work with. I wish you all a very well-deserved summer break. The music today was arranged and performed by Susan Clark, Matt Bashford, Sean Hanlon, and the Music and Sound class. Rob Kelly, Deirdre O'Leary, and Ronan Power are responsible for sound and video, and Bobby McClune for the montage. Will Carty, Christine Carroll, Vilma Lemonite, Teresa Butler and Honorata Butt have put in many hours in the background in preparation for this event. Our events committee is headed up by Hilda Coughlin. It's comprised of Zara Sheridan, Patrice Byrne, Bernie Leahy, Chris Yangi, Caroline McCann and Cliona Murphy, and is responsible for the full organisation of the graduation, all four ceremonies. This is an enormous undertaking and comes at our busiest time of year. Thanks to Hilda and her team, the grad now runs like a well-oiled machine, and I'd like to thank them on everyone's behalf. I'd also like to thank the hotel for hosting us today. Can I call on Hilda to come up now for a presentation, please? To hear. Onto the stage, Hilda. Onto the stage, Zara.
Thank you so much. Can I say something?
Can, of course.
I just want to say that it was my vision and dream this year to have a graduation as such as this in the hotel. It was a poor substitute to having your graduation at home in the last 2 years of the pandemic, and I'm really delighted that you're all here today. Thank you.
But our last word, as always, has to be to you, the students. All of you here today are living proof that education is for life and for all stages of life. All of you have displayed an inner drive, motivation, and strength. You are amongst a very small number of students in history to have studied throughout a pandemic, and we stand before you today acknowledging that this has not been easy. Yet here you are, graduating. What an achievement. Education opens minds and opens doors. The education you received here in Dunboyne has opened your minds. The qualification you receive will open doors for you. We hope that all of you have got what you wanted from this year. But remember that whatever your results, your year in Dunboyne College is one short chapter of your life, and your results are just a single snapshot of what you're capable of. Right now, you must choose the next chapter you're going to write. So this is not the end game. Remember our motto, begin here and go anywhere. We're all continuously learning and changing. Us, your teachers, everyone. We never really get there. We're all on a journey. We'll all have setbacks and successes and steep learning curves. So it doesn't stop when you leave college. It doesn't really stop ever. So this is most definitely not the end game for you. The point of it all is to stick with it, bounce back from setbacks, and try again. Albert Einstein said, "It's not that I'm so very intelligent, I just stay with the problem longer." So while intelligence is great, perseverance, hard work, and determination are probably more important factors in determining success in life. We in Dunboyne College wish you every success in life. We wish you good luck. Please keep in touch with us. It's been a pleasure and a privilege for us to have you as students this past year. Thank you.
Thank you. together.
What a way to finish. Two brilliant numbers with our sound production teacher, Rob Kelly, on drums. Give him a round of applause as well. He did very well there. Moonlighting on the other end of the camera. Just two final announcements. Again, just if you can return the caps and gowns over the next while, please, as soon as you can. And also, you're still welcome to get pictures taken, photographs in the hallway and the way. And if you didn't get a chance before the ceremony, you can certainly do it afterwards. So again, whatever you do, enjoy the rest of the evening. And thanks for being here today. And as they say in the cartoons, that's all, folks.